welcome to my channel. This is Lizelle, and I have another Get Ready With Me for you. I'm just gonna do a look that I did yesterday. So much stuff has happened since the last time I posted a video. I have a lot to talk about. So this is probably gonna be another long, chatty Get Ready With Me vlog thing. Anyways, let's get started. I'm still filming on my phone, the iPhone 7 Plus, and this time I have the screen, I'm using the selfie camera. So we're also like testing out the quality of the front facing camera on the iPhone 7 Plus, just to throw that in there. Going back to, you know, last video and what happened in between, I want to start doing this every week. I don't like go out as much anymore, and I need like a creative project to help keep me busy. And I'm an artist. As you can see, those are my two paintings I have ready for anyone who's interested. I don't, you know, showcase my artwork a lot. I sell my artwork pretty quick. Most of my transactions don't involve like a third party. And I'm always working, so I like never have time to do it. I feel like some people don't think I am a real artist, but I feel like I am because I live that lifestyle every day. You know, I'm definitely not like, you know, booking fancy shows or anything like that, but you know, I have a few little things here and there. I have a few new products. I kind of changed the way I did my makeup recently. I got rid of the NYX HD eye primer because it kind of sucks, to be honest. Like, I was just using that because I wasn't like I didn't know that you could use concealer as an eye primer. So I've been doing that a lot. I just feel like the NYX HD eyeshadow primer is a little too watery and thin. To my liking, and I feel like this works just as well, if not better. And this is the Age Rewind in medium. I'm gonna dab this all over. Okay, so my life has been fucking crazy because about 3 weeks ago I was laid off from Sprig, and in between that time I was unemployed, looking for work. I found work. I'm very grateful for that. It feels like I'm always like bouncing around between jobs. It really sucks. I'm like tired of it. Like, why do I have to keep doing that? It's frustrating too. It's like as soon as I settle into a place, I have to go somewhere else. Getting laid off wasn't so bad because I've been laid off before and like, you know, not get anything. When I was laid off with Sprig, they gave us a severance check and held a job fair for us, and like 25 companies came out to hire us. I forgot to put something right here. And I thought that was really, really sweet for them to do that. Now, the restaurant industry is tough. It's competitive for no reason. It's like, it's just fucking food, you know? I'm highlighting my face right now. I felt a little sidetracked. It's you know, changing jobs is super stressful. It's really annoying, to be honest. But I'm glad I found something now. I'm not allowed to talk about where I work because I signed a contract stating that. And what I'm doing now isn't even like a big deal, you know? Like I'm just a barista somewhere or at a cafe. But it's in like office building. So my hours are very early. I work 5 days a week for 8 hours. I have to wake up early, which kind of sucks. When I was working at Sprig, I was closing, so I'd be there from like 3 till like 10:30, sometimes 11. And so I had to change my whole sleep schedule. I get up at 4:30, clock in at 7, and clock out usually before 3:30, a little after 3 most of the time. I'm the only barista there, so like it's kind of like my station, and I'm in charge of all that. And I still, you know, make latte art even though I'm not receiving tips, because I'm dedicated like that. I just really like making latte art. It's pretty fun, and I like working with an espresso machine. Oh, I'm done highlighting my face. I got rid of the NYX Brow Powder Duo because one less step. So the coffee that we serve is 4-barrel. We have like a license with them. They're basically our supplier for our coffee. And it's a pretty cool company. Like, it's a very, they're really into metal music. And so their aesthetic is that. a lot of goats and pentagrams and stuff like that. And it's cute. Cute in like a good way, you know, not like cute in a sissy way or anything like that. And I love 4-barrel coffee. I like Blue Bottle too. I think I'm gonna put this on, even though it's a little warm. Yeah, it's really hard for me to handle my debt if I keep changing jobs all the time. And then my income changes too, so that's always a nightmare. Like sometimes I'll score a pretty decent job that's giving me like a steady wage, and that's cool. Or like sometimes I'll get lucky and then get like a pretty nice check and like just stock up on things I need around the house, that kind of shit. So, I noticed that in my last video I was saying so and anyways a lot, and I was like, oh, why do I do that? That's so dumb. A little trick I like to do is using my lighter bronzer. This is the bronzer I used in the winter time. It's way too late for me now, but I like taking this. This is the Rimmel bronzer in Sun Bronze. I like taking this and like using it as a transition shade, and it kind of helps set the concealer too. It also makes like a good everyday like shadow. you're in a rush. That's like kind of my go-to makeup look for work. It's just bronzer on my eyes. I mean, I can't get too creative or crazy with my makeup at work because it's kind of like, you know, it's a lunch spot, so it's not really a place where I can like play around with makeup. It's a little different from like other cafe jobs where I can like be all cute and hip and trendy or whatever. So I have to keep my makeup mellow. Every once in a while I'll throw in like an exciting lipstick, but for the most part I keep it natural. Oh, so in my last video I didn't talk about the concealer I was using on my face. And I'm still using the same concealer even though I complained about it. So I'm gonna use this on my scars and any like discolored spots. It's a little darker than the other one. This one is in, it's a medium deep. It's the L'Oreal True Match. Oh, so the craziest thing happened yesterday. I went to Lake Merritt. For those of you new, I live in Oakland. I live in Oakland, California, and I go to Lake Merritt a lot to day drink and hang out. And yesterday, I went to go meet up with my friend and smoke a joint. And in California, marijuana is legal for recreational use. I use it for medicinal use and recreational use. Oh god, look at that. That looks so weird. I kind of want to... Alright, so it looks somewhat normal. Anyway, so I go there, meet up with my friend. We're like, hey now. Another one of his buddies shows up. I've never met him before, and I only met him briefly. And then he takes off. And then a drone starts like flying next to us. And I'm pretty sure it's not like, you know, a big deal or whatever, like it's nothing. But it's just, those things are so creepy. Drones are so creepy. It's like, oh my god, someone is watching you, you know? You don't know who that is. And it's probably, I mean, for all, you know, it could just be some kid. Some like teenager, it's hella rich and just doesn't have shit to do. Except be a mischievous butthead. That's what I would do if I was rich. If I was a rich kid, I would just be all up in people's business for no reason. Because I'm terrible. I'm kidding. Oh, I'm still using the NYX Liquid Illuminator. This thing kind of sucks, but I noticed that it works better when I pat it in with my finger instead of like, you know, rubbing it around. But you know, makeup is fun. I mean, I'm trying to not go out so much and drink and all that, so it's if I'm not spending it on booze, like, the money's gonna be spent on booze anyway, so I might as well just spend it on a healthier substitute. So I'm using this e.l.f. illuminating palette. It's this guy. I didn't like this at first, but then I started to like it a little bit more as I was using it. I like to use this yellow. I use this one, this color, on my cheeks. And now I'm about to go in with this one, the yellowish one, and just do my nose. Then I'm taking this old MAC concealer brush and just, you know, getting ahead of myself and placing that brow bone highlight right there. Okay. Ah, so glowy. Do you guys notice the difference? I hope that wasn't too scary. I picked up this blue highlighter by NYX. It's their duochrome. It's a blue highlighter, basically. Let's see. Does it swatch? A little bit. And it literally just, it is what it says. It gives like a twilight tint. Add a little detail by changing a small thing like my highlighter cheeks. And I feel like, you know, like the tops of your cheeks are like the best place for strange highlighters, because it's close to your eye, and if you're doing like a crazy eyeshadow look, like it'll go together very well. Can you see it? It's a little blue. Do you see that? And I would just apply it just here and then leave everything else alone. I thought that was, you know, story time was gonna be a lot longer, but it was pretty short. I was like a month in to learning a new position at the job. At Sprig. And then, like, you know, the company went under, so we all lost our job. But they gave us a severance check, and I've been living off of that the past month, trying really hard not to spend it all in one place and, you know, pay down some of my bills and still, like, you know, be creative and also try not to lose my mind and also, like, not spend it all on booze. But, you know, surprisingly, I should give myself more credit, but I haven't gone out really, I think, once since I was, like, let go, and that was to celebrate finding a job a week later, or no, was it? It was, like, 2 weeks after I was laid off. Woo, man. That was nuts. Still using the Venus palette. And I am going in with Jam. I'm just gonna put it all over there. And, dude, I'm surprised I haven't lost my shit. Like, how am I, like, not... How am I not losing my shit? I think it's all the weed. The weed is doing it. Shout out to my friend Adam for, like, opening up his bike shop. His bike shop is called Oakland Service Course. It's on East 18th. And I remember him, like, chatting with me about it. And I have a business degree, so I know a little bit about business. I mean, I'm an artist. I do okay for, you know, where I'm at. I mean, I do okay. I mean, I'm not, like, super successful, but I feel like I have, like, a good idea of stuff. And anyways, so I'm really happy for him because He's like super busy all the time, and like he's killing it. It's working. Things are working out for him. Now I'm gonna go in with filter. This blue. It's not that neon. I wish it was. That would be really cool. But it's a sky blue. I think my favorite thing about like Get Ready With Me's and like the whole makeup YouTube community is the people. Or no, it's like, yeah, it is the people, like their personalities and stuff. It's so cute. Like sometimes I just like, you know, winding down after a long day and like hearing like Laura Lee or Jeffree Star's voice, and it just like makes me happy. They have like such cute, quirky personalities. The LA like YouTube community is totally killing it. I mean, I'm not trying to be like a beauty guru or whatever. I just really enjoy playing with makeup and like chatting. While I'm doing makeup, it reminds me of me and my sister when we were closer. Like, we would, you know, do our makeup before school and just chat, and it was fun. We would just talk about whatever was on our minds, and, you know, I miss doing that. I mean, we kind of just went our separate ways. Made different life decisions, and my family dynamic is very intense and kind of scary, so I won't really get into that. It's just like unnecessary, you know, for it to be the way it is. To my outer corner, and I'm using Mud. Ooh, I like the glitter. I'm using Mud on the outer corner just to give it more depth. And then I'm also gonna go in with Mud, the same color, on my lower line, just to, you know, keep it together. So I don't know what's going on with my love life. It's pretty vague. I don't know what's going on. Cause like, to be honest, like I think I have a stalker, but I'm not sure. I don't know. Every time I try to talk to someone about it, they just say I'm crazy. And you know, that's fine. I mean, I used to have a cat. I mean, I could just be a crazy cat lady. Okay, so this is what I have so far. Little crusties. Just a little pop of blue. I don't know, the world's fucking crazy and people are nuts. I mean, I get sexually harassed a lot, you know, because I'm a girl and guys don't know how to handle themselves and it's all our fault. What can you do? So, I'm also gonna go in with Fly, and I'm gonna put it on top of the blue, just to, you know, brighten it up a little bit more. And I also just love putting shimmery eyeshadow on the middle of my lid, on top of like matte shadows, because it just adds more oomph. Know what to talk about. It's hard to find things to talk about because I feel like I'm talking into nothing. I know I just started doing these the vlogs. This is my second one. Okay. Now I'm going back in. I'm gonna go in with my Wet n Wild eyeliner. Just outline the top and half of the bottom. The Bay Area is expensive. I don't know how I'm still here. I'm like amazed. How am I still living here? I had to learn to be smart with my money really quick. This is my old Mac 266. angle brush. And I like to go in with like the darkest color, which is Boots. Do a little of this. I just love how sparkly that is. See the purple and the green? That's so cool. Alright. And I'm just gonna put it in the outer corner. But for mascara, I got this little sample of Monsieur Big from, I think it's Lacombe. And I think it's called Monsieur Big because look at this brush. It's so stumpy though. Alright, so I'm gonna put this on my lashes. You know what? Doing like these types of videos is actually pretty fun and kind of therapeutic in a way. I mean, I'm not trying to be like, you know, YouTube famous overnight. I don't know why I did that face. And I know that, you know, people don't make money off of YouTube, but just like chatting and sharing things with strangers on the internet, it's kind of fun. I tried doing like a feminist YouTube show like 2 years ago or a year ago, something like that, and it was so scary. Like, I thought it was gonna be, you know, cute and sweet and all that, you know, girls banding together and, you know, la-di-dee la-di-da. And like, some of my first comments were so scary. Mm-hmm. They're like, fuck you, feminazi cunt. And I was like, shit, dude, fuck. Am I gonna get murdered when I go outside? God damn. Like, ew. Okay. Seriously though, ew. Okay, so the eyes are done. The Neutrogena Healthy Skin Blush in Flushed. And it's just a coral pink. Not too many like YouTubers talk about like Neutrogena products. I like this blush. I think it's kind of cute. Oh. Excuse me. Using it like a mirror. Ooh! That was too much. Very pigmented. I keep forgetting like how pigmented that is. I'm sorry, I can't take... You know, I put my, the cardigan on because I noticed that my little chichis. My chichis were showing, so I'm just gonna do this. Like, they seriously look like little vaginas. So gross. Okay, so now that I've toned down my cheeks by aggressively doing this, so I'm done with blush. I think I'm going to get like a new face powder because I don't really like this anymore. Like, I want to give the other ones, other brands a try. YouTubers like make some of the products you use sound so nice that like it makes me wonder if what I'm using is crap. I mean, NYX isn't crap. They have, like, pretty good makeup, but it's also hit or miss. I feel like it's not really much different from, like, Maybelline or L'Oreal or any, like, drugstore. It's kind of, like, in that quality category. So the color I used yesterday is by Maybelline, and it's from their nude collection, Toasted Truffle. I'm just gonna put it on to like show you. I think Laura Lee already swatched this in one of her videos, but here it is on my skin tone, on my face. Okay. So this is Toasted Truffle. I like mixing this in with their other nudes that didn't really look that great on me. But I like the color, I thought it was pretty. Since my cheeks are coral, I'll just do a touch of this. Their Naked Coral. See, it looks like it would look cute, but it's a little pop in the middle. Alright, so this is like my makeup look yesterday. I love wearing makeup, it's fun. I'm going to do my black lipstick. Look. I don't wear black lipstick often, but sometimes when I'm going to the bar and I don't feel like talking to a dude, I'll just like wear black lipstick just to seem a little bit more intimidating. And sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. Recently, I feel like it doesn't work. Like, guys still wanna, like, fucking touch me. I don't know. I'm not really into that. I don't like it when strangers touch me. Some people are into that, but not everyone, okay? So I'm just, like, blotting my lips, so that not too much of the lip balm stays on. Take my eyeliner, I sharpen it so that the eye cooties don't touch the lip cooties. I don't know if it actually does anything, but I feel better when I do it. And what I use to do my black lips, I didn't have a black, I lost my black lipstick, so I had to get this Katy Perry one. To be honest, I don't like these lipsticks at all. They taste gross. But I got the, you know, the Katy Perry matte lipstick in Perry Panther. I mean, the packaging is really cute, but it still has that CoverGirl smell. It smells like perfume and cologne. Perfume and cologne. It smells like, yeah, it just smells like perfume. And it tastes like it too. It's fucking gross. And for lip gloss, this is discontinued. Lime Crime doesn't carry this anymore. It's their Carousel Gloss in Serpentine. I probably should toss this because it's that old, but you know, it's one of my, I couldn't let it go. But look at this, it's in a twirly bottle. Just love the packaging, it's so cute. This lip gloss is so gross. It looks intense though, right? Equal sign. All right. Yeah, it took me like a couple of uses before I figured out how to use this properly. I'm pretty sure someone's done this look before, so sorry if I'm copying. Here we go. When I was in high school, I used to outline my lips in black and fill it in with red every single day. Every day. It just brings back memories, like seeing my lips like this. It didn't look like this, but you know, I would just like outline my lips so that it would, so I wouldn't have to go in with concealer, because I didn't use concealer back then. Okay. And then I'm gonna go fill it in with this nasty ass like CoverGirl lipstick. Nasty ass. Ugh. Gross. And I'm going in with the gloss. I love that noise. Here it is. It doesn't really go. I think it looks better with the dark brown. I don't know. I'm so shy. Oh, sorry. And sometimes if I'm feeling like this is too, you know, I like this. I really like this. This is so nice. Ugh. Gross. But you see how that lip gloss does that? Not good. That's why I was like doing this, like, you know, because it's supposed to. That's supposed to be a trick to not get lipstick on your teeth. Instead, I got half of my lipstick. This whole combination is really disgusting. It looks pretty, like, I like it a lot, but it tastes nasty. It's really sticky. It looks cool, but it's not cool at all. So anyways, so this is my crazy fantastic makeup look. I would probably wear this like if I was going out tonight at a bar. I feel like when you're going to a club or going to like a nice little bar or lounge, you can get away with wearing like crazy makeup looks and stuff like that. But yeah, but I definitely can't wear this at work. Like if I did, people would be like, what the fuck are you doing? I'll be like, oh. Ugh, God, that's so gross. Can you imagine, like, what's kind of cute about it is, you know, the glitter, but I have to go back in with that nasty ass, like, I dropped it. That nasty ass lipstick. See, now it's like gray, but not really, because it's super patchy. Maybe I should just get rid of those, the lipstick and the lip gloss, because I'm just like, I don't know what I'm doing at this point. I don't know if I'm torturing myself in front of you, or if I'm like torturing the viewers. I'm done playing. I'm done playing games. Let me take this gross ass lip situation off. Oh, am I a YouTuber yet? Oh god, it's so fucking gross. Alright. Come back, toast the truffle. Get back in my life. Okay, after that whole situation, I'm gonna call it the black lipstick look from hell. Nothing's more fitting for a title than that. Or if there is, please leave a comment down below. Oh god. This is heaven or hell. Alright. Okay, so I feel more sane now. Alright, so voila. Thanks for hanging out with me and, you know, sticking around on this journey. Thank you so much. Anyways, have a good one, and till next time, bye.